I was 20 past three, all packed, nearly ready to go, and he was just wiping down the bench.
I stopped over in Wagga in the rain and found a motel after checking out a few of them, and we had a nice one with a spa with the NBN.
Well, we had a noisy morning in Hay with a couple of semis there camped overnight loaded with cotton. Well, I camped in a POW camp in the last war. We're going to head off to Balranald. We're at Euston, a QE caravan park for nomads, and we're just going down to the Murrumbidgee River. This guy owns lots of Volkswagens and Combis and other assorted vehicles. It's washing away with the 2 inches of rain they just had. Just stopping for lunch outside of Merbein in the junction of the Pooncarry and Wentworth Road on our way up to Kinchega. And I love you so. Well, this is as good as it gets on the Darling River at Camp 33 at Kinchega National Park. This is just with the little headlamp with two AAA batteries in it. And we're just getting dinner here after a couple of whiskies. And it's dead calm. And we're just sorting out what we can have for dinner in there in the tent. And it's a lovely evening. It'll be full moon tomorrow night. And here we are doing our ablutions beside the Darling River. The river is somewhere down here, under the River Red Gums. We'll check this out tomorrow in the morning sunshine. It'll be just perfect. And camping doesn't get much better than this. When the campsite's about a mile apart, the moon's rising above. The serenity.
My hairdo.
repels the serenity. It's not less flow than when we were here before. There was no exposed sand like that.
Have you got him still?
No, he keeps moving.
Yeah, he is.
Cut.
Snag in the water there actually. So whether they expect there'll be a few little fish there or something.
Looking for land and fish. We spoke to Steve, who's camping down there with his son. And they caught a Murray cod in night time. They caught a
big one.
A large carp as well. Looks like he's collecting thongs. And Steve's gone into town for supplies. The old steam traction engine was placed here and just there in 1880 to power the first shears called bog eyes. See the photo I have of that backlit on Flickr.
That steam engine out there ran a belt through to here for the sharpening of the blades. It was very noisy. That's for turning on your shears and pull the string attached to the air. There's some nice stills I have of the timber around this. Well, I think I've re-photographed it enough. Yeah.